Hello again. I want to share with you a couple of vintage leather filofaxes from the 1990s. In this case, they're two identical personal size filofaxes. This one, which is one I use every day, this is a reference filofax for household bills and banking stuff, etc. And I know I bought this in 1993 in W.H. Smith's. I think I paid, back in the day, $49.99 or $49.95. There we go. Which was probably quite expensive 20 years ago. But 50 quid for a calf leather filofax 20 years ago. How much would that be now? Who knows? But these are slightly different. I think these are a transitional phase. Most of you will know that Filofax stopped producing binders in the UK in the early 1990s. I know I bought this one in 1993. I'm not sure about the age of this one because I'm not the first owner. However, this one is almost mint condition. Doesn't look like it's been used in anger at all. But what I like about them is the fact that there's no issue with flatability at all. Okay, this is a, all intents and purposes, brand new filofax, and there's no flatability. However, the construction method is different to earlier filofaxes. Now, this is a calf leather filofax. It doesn't actually have a designation. In the early days, as you know, filofax had a very simple way of designating filofaxes. For instance, 3CL. So if a filofax was 3CL, you knew it had three pockets and it was made of calf leather. That's the way it works. But later filofaxes have a grandiose name, designed to evoke images of England's green and pleasant land in the minds of buyers who perhaps like that sort of thing, which is not a bad thing at all in my book. But this particular one, this particular model, has no name, no designator at all. So I'm curious as to why that is. But the construction is slightly different to I'm getting tongue-tied here, to filofaxes that were made in England before this one, generally. It's calf leather. However, it does have, I don't know whether you can hear this. There we go. It has some sort of stiffener in there that ends at this hinge point. And similarly, you've got a stiffener in here as well. There we go. And it ends there, so allowing a degree of flatability that not every filofax enjoys when it's brand new. Now, I've seen modern filofaxes that have this leather, and sandwiched between the leather is a stiffener that seems to go all the way from one side to the other, encompassing the spine and making flatability a bit of a problem. Unless you like filofaxes that you can struggle to open and even struggle some more to keep flat. So even though this filofax has stiffeners in, the fact that the stiffener seems to be in perhaps two or maybe three separate parts, it feels like, oh, it's hard to tell. I think there is some sort of stiffener on the spine, but The stiffener is actually in three parts, so the joint has lots of flexibility, which I think is good. Okay, and then if you go back further than this, you'll find that a single piece of calf leather for a personal filofax does seem to start off very, very stiff. So it has the same flatability problems as a modern filofax with the sort of alleged man-made stiffener inside. I've actually put a video on last year showing a dissected modern filofax, which you may have seen before. But anyway, what I also like about this filofax is the fact that you've got a secure full-length pocket for stuff that won't fall out when the filofax is shut. But you've also got a pocket here which is pointing this way, so that if the filofax is shut like that, you can only you can open the filofax and get your stuff out without having to open it and then fiddle about and have to open it fully. So you've got one pocket opening inwards and one pocket opening outwards, and then you've got another full length pocket here, again opening outwards, which is quite useful, to be honest. 8 credit card slots and, holy of holies, 2 pen slots. And these pen slots are made, I don't know whether you can see that, they're actually constructed with a single piece of leather, so you can see the underside of the leather in there, rather than the modern way, if you can call it that, where they have a thinner piece of leather that they fold over to make double the thickness, so that the leather itself is thinner, half as thin, fold it over, twice as thick, and that's how they do it. And this one's got 2. Again, the strap, it seems to be 2 pieces of leather sewn together, but without the sort of rubber padding that I've come across on modern filofaxes, which is inserted to make it look like it's chunkier leather. This actually looks like it's just an all leather construction with no sort of inserted man-made sandwich, if you like, inside. So there we go. I've no idea what the designation of this filofax is, but I'm actually a fan of this transitional stage in the early 90s before they moved on to filofaxes made elsewhere. So there we go. Another pair of vintage filofaxes, this time made in England, but in the 1990s. Thanks very much for watching.